So, dear student, today I will teach you about the half adder and full adder in digital electronics. I, Rakesh Jain from Gyanvir University, going to teach you in digital electronics a very special topic of a combinational circuit, that is half adder and full adder. Actually, whenever we want a 2-bit addition, then we require a combinational circuit, and that combinational circuit is known as half adder. So, first we will study about the half adder, the circuitry, the truth table. Then, on a multisim software, we will check, we will design, and we will see the verification of the half adder using multisim software. So first of all, just see this MS Paint 5. Yes, so our topic name is half adder. A half adder is actually a combinational circuit. Combinational circuit means they can be designed with the help of the logic gates. As I have already been taught you about NOR gate, NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, XNOR gate. So, with the help of universal logic gate, NAND and NOR, so those are logic gates, and with the help of those logic gates, some circuitry are designed in which the output depends only on the inputs. Okay, there is no memory element. So that is known as a combinational circuit, like half adder, full adder, half subtractor, full subtractor, multiplexer, demultiplexer, decoder, encoder. These are certain circuitry which we will study later on. So first of all, a combinational circuit name is half adder, actually used whenever we want 2-bit addition, right? It requires for 2-bit addition. It requires for 2-bit addition, right? So first of all, which type of circuitry is there? Then for a half adder, we require a XOR gate and a AND gate. So first of all, let's see the circuitry of the half adder. Because we require only 2 bits for the addition, and we know that whenever 2 bits are added, either the result will be there, either result with carry will be there, because in case of binary is also 1, and 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry, 1 plus 1. So now see the circuit of half adder. We require XOR, increase the, yes, so this is my XOR gate. This is my XOR gate. For the half adder, we require one XOR gate and one AND gate. And I know the symbol of AND gate. As we see that AND gate is like this one. AND gate is like this one. This is my XOR gate and this is my AND gate. Okay. So just connect these two inputs of XOR gate with the help of two inputs of these XOR gate with the two inputs of NAND gate. One is connected with one, and second is connected It is very clearly seen that the total circuitry consists two input. Let's suppose the first input I mentioned I abbreviated by A, and the second input I abbreviate B. Okay, then the output of this is there are two outputs, because we know that whenever two bits are added in case of binary addition, either carry will be generated, either no carry generated, but there the result will be sum. Half adder means a circuitry, a combinational circuit, which will add two bits, and as a result, it will generate sum. Sum means the result after addition, and carry. Carry means if 1 plus 1 will be there, then 1 plus 1 result is 0 and carry will be generated. So, the next carry is 0. So, one output is known as sum and one output is known as carry. And here there are two inputs, one is A and one is B. So, these A and B are your input side, these are your input side. And these two sum and carry are your output side. These are your outputs. So, inputs and outputs. So, what gates we require for the competition exam? You should remember that we require one XOR gate. And one AND gate. The inputs are A and B and the outputs are sum and carry. Now, if we talk about the truth table of this XOR gate, then see very carefully. Now, see, one side is of input and one side is of outputs. There are two inputs, A and B. One input is A. Second input are B, and there are two outputs, one is sum output and the second one is carry output. Now see, because there are two inputs, it means how many number of combinations can be there of inputs, either 0 0, either 0 1, either 1 0 or either 1 1. So, there are possibility of 4 combinations 0 0, 0 1, 1 0 and 1 1. So, let for the truth table we just write down this. Zero 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 one zero and the last one is 1 1. So there are four possible. Now, what is the output sum and what is the carry output? Now see very carefully, it is the XOR gate. And what do you know about the XOR gate? If both the inputs are same, then the output will be 0. Sum comes from the output of a XOR gate. Sum is the output of XOR gate. And we know the truth table of a XOR gate, that XOR gate output is 0 whenever both inputs are same. So, here see 0 and 0 is there. 0 and 0 is there. It means 0 0 is same. so sum is 0. 1, 1 is same, so again this is 0, otherwise it is 1, because sum comes from the, sum output comes from the XOR gate. And what is the true table of XOR gate? XOR gate definition is what? If both input are same, output will be 0. So 0 and 0, 0, 1 and 1, then 0. Otherwise 0, 1, the output is 1. 1, 0, then output is 1. It depends on the inputs A and B. If A and B both values are same, then the sum output, which is actually output of XOR gate, is 0. If A and B inputs value are different from each other, then the XOR output sum will be 1. And what is the carry output? Now see in the diagram, the carry output comes from the AND gate. And what we know about the AND gate? Any input is 0, output is 0. Any input is 0, output is 0. Now, while writing down the carry, do not see this sum, because sum is one output and we want to write down the output for the carry, and carry output depends on the input. And where is the input? Input are A and B. So C, only C, A and B. Any input is 0, then output is 0. A is 0, B is 0. 0 we find, that's why output is 0. A is 0, B is 1. A is 0, B is 1. Because 1, 0 we find, that's why 0. A is 1, but B is 0. Again we find 0, so again 0. A and B both are 1, 1. No 0 we find, that's why 1. So this will be the truth table of a half adder. Kindly wait, I just save this file. Combinational circuit, which is used for the 2-bit addition, and during the time of addition, either we find out the result, either we find out some carry with the result. So there will be a two possibility of output, sum and carry. So here we use a XOR gate and a gate to find out the output. The inputs of the AND gate is connected directly with the inputs of XOR gate. The inputs are A and B, and the output of XOR is noted as, nominated as sum, and the AND gate output as carry. So when we check the truth table, then if A input and B input both are 0, 0, then the sum output will be 0 and carry output will also be 0. If A input is 0, B is 1, then sum output will be 1, but carry output is 0. If A is 1, B is 0, at that time the sum output is 1 and carry output is 0. If both are 1, 1, then sum output is 0, but carry output is 1, because AND gate circuitry is there. So these are different possibilities. Is it clear? Now, while how we can perform this on a multisim software? Now we are going to test it on a multisim software. So first of all, tree and show you the results at that time. With this truth table, you can check the results. You can check the results. So just to take a snapshot. Okay. Now I am showing you the multisim software. Yes, the multisim software will be on. Now we require a XOR gate and an AND gate. So go to MISC, then MISC Digital, then go to XOR gate. Where is the XOR gate? So here is the XOR gate. So just OK by left click, and left click again to paste here. So we require one XOR gate and one AND gate. So where is the AND gate? Just see in MISC Digital again. You can type over here directly, so the AND gate will be come. this one will be your input. Now what kind of connections was there? The AND gate 2 points and XOR gate 2 points are connected directly. So this 1-1, this first input is connected with the first one, and the second will be connected with the second one. Now to provide the input, we connect switches so that we will provide the inputs, and with the help of those switches we can switch 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 0, 0 positions. So go to MISC again, connect these switches. In basics you will find out these switches. Switch, then just use two switches. Here the first switch noted as first input B. So depends on the position of these A and B, we consider the name there. So first input is noted as A, and the second one, to I just change the name from A to B. Okay, so these are two inputs. These are two inputs. So these are two inputs separately. I use them just to connect with these two input lines. So one with the one, sorry, one with the first point of XOR gate, and second one with the second point of XOR gate, or we can say with both the XOR and AND gate, right? Okay, first with the first line and second with the second line, in a simple language I can say. So now connect these both switches from one end and connect with a power supply. So for the connection of the power supply, we go to sources, then power sources, then VCC. Go to VCC, then OK. And VCC we always require 5 volt. Right. Now to check the result at the output, we should connect some LEDs over there. So for that we require current limiting resistor. So I connect current limiting resistor from the basic 100 ohm current limiting resistor for the LEDs. So at the output side there are two outputs, so I require two LEDs, 200 ohm resistor, current limiting resistors. One for the XOR gate output and one for the AND gate output. And just connect the LEDs. Let the one output will be shown by the red LED and the second one by the yellow LED. That the one output will be shown by the red LED and the second one will be by this. The positive terminal of the LED is connect with the, and just rotate it or just flip it, so you can easily connect there. Okay, now you can see easily. This 100 ohm is also connected with the positive terminal. The negative terminal of the LEDs are connected with the ground. So again go to source, then go to ground, analog ground, that's why we can say ground, simple ground. Okay. So here I connect one ground and here for the second LED. So whenever this red light will be glow, red LED will be glow at the output side, it means sum is 1, because it red LED represent you the sum. So I just change the name so that you will be easily find them. So I put the name sum over here, and this yellow LED denoted for the put it at the lower side. Okay, so these are two outputs, one is for sum and one is for carry. Now for the input side, we again connect these 100 ohm resistors for the current limiting of LEDs. So how many inputs are there? Two for the XOR gate and two for the AND gates. Alright. So to show you easily, we just see one 100 ohm here and 100 ohm here. Just rotate them. So these two lines show you two input side for both the XOR gate and for the AND gate. Now connect two LEDs over here. So let the first input will be shown by the green LED. Put a green LED over here. And let the second one is shown by a yellow LED. Okay. So here again a yellow LED. So connect the positive of the cases. Yes, and the negative terminal with the ground. Negative terminal with the ground. Now see, both the positive terminal are connected with the one end of 100 ohm resistor and the negative terminal is connected with the ground. Negative terminal is connected with the ground. Now these are the current limiting resistor 100 ohm. Now for the current limiting of these logic gates, we just have to connect 1 kilo ohm resistance. So we just use 1 kilo ohm resistance for it. 1K, then OK. One resistance is for this first input and one resistance for this second input side. See very carefully. Now one end is connected with the first input and one end of the second 1 kilo ohm resistance is connected with the second input side. Yes, and the second end is connected with the ground. So I just copy here any ground terminal. Kindly wait. Wait, kindly wait. Okay, now it's okay. Okay, now this is my LED. But the ground terminal is connected with here and plus terminal is connected with the output 100 ohm. This one is with negative. Okay, everything is fine. So the second terminal of 1 kilo ohm resistance is connected with the ground. So I just copy a ground terminal from there and just paste here and again paste it for this terminal. Yes. So my whole circuitry is completed. The output name are sum and carry. The output name are sum and carry. And the inputs name are A and B. Okay. So, and the required power supply is 5 volt, and there are some LEDs which show you the inputs and outputs. The output can be shown by red LED for sum, yellow LED for carry output, and the inputs can be shown by the green LED as first input A and yellow LED as the second input B. Okay. See very carefully if there is any connection which is mistakenly. No, there is all connections are fine. Okay, then file the design, save the design, and just check the result. Okay, so once again I am showing you the same MS Paint file where I draw the truth table of this half adder. Then we will again come to this Multisim software, and on this design we just check the result and verify that the truth table was correct. So this is
अम्बेडकर अम्बेडकर हाँ बोल रहा बेटी सुनाना हो तरह की
बोलना
करोगे, की
कुछ ना
करोगे वीडियो
कुछ ना।
वीडियो में
बोल
पा मफले मफले सब बांध के रखना है रे।
चल बोल की गई बोल ना
कब
की करवे नु तोरो तोरो टाइम आ तो तोहु ना जा रे भी
अच्छा
तो ऑफ कर दे ली रे
तो की करिए थे ऑफ कर ली तो हम ही करती है
सर। चेक
यस सो वंस अगेन आई एम कमिंग ड्यू टू सम इंटरप्शन द लाइट्स आर कट ऑफ दैट्स व्हाई देयर वाज सम इंटरप्शन नाउ आई एम अगेन हियर आर यू एबल टू हियर मी टेल मी वन टाइम आर यू एबल टू हियर मी डियर डियर
यस सर
स्टूडेंट्स आर यू
यस
एबल
सर
यस वेरी गुड वेरी गुड सो आई एम अगेन प्रेजेंटिंग यू दैट एम एस पेंट फाइल इन विच आई ड्रॉ द सर्किट ऑफ एक्सोर गेट एंड वी सॉ द ट्रुथ टेबल Then I again reopen the multisim software, show you the connections which we did few minutes ago, and then verify the results. First of all, we just open that. I am going to show you that MS Paint file. Kindly wait. Yes. So here, are you able to see this MS Paint file right now? Are
No
you
sir.
able to see this
Yes sir.
MS Paint file right now?
No sir. Yes sir.
Okay, very good. Yes, very good. Yes. So this was what circuit of half adder. See the circuit very carefully. Here we require a XOR gate and a AND gate. The XOR gate have two inputs A and B. These two inputs are directly connected also with the AND gates, and the outputs are denoted as sum and carry. See the truth table which we are going to verify with the help of multisim software. Whenever A and B both inputs are 0, at that time the sum output is 0 and carry output is 0. Whenever A input is 0 and B input is 1, at that time the sum output will be 1 and the carry output will be 0. Whenever A input is 1, B input is 0, both the inputs are 1, then the sum output will be 0 and the carry output will be 1. So this is the truth table. And now, as few minutes ago, we just make the connections on multisim software, and again I am reopening that design to show in front of you. Now see that multisim design. Yes. So are you able to see the circuitry which we just connected few minutes ago on multisim software? Wait for a while. Wait for a while. Yes, yes, yes. Wait for a while. Yes. Now see the design. So this was the design which we just connected few minutes ago before the lights are cut off. There are two, one XOR gate, one AND gate, two input XOR gate and two input AND gate. The output of sum and carry, the sum output represented by a red LED here, and the carry output is represented by a yellow LED here. And the two inputs of XOR gate are also directly connected with the two inputs of AND gate, where the first input of them connected with the power supply via a 5 volt switch. Via a switch to 5 volt supply, and the second input is connected from a switch from the power supply via a switch, via the second switch was we represented by B, which we represented by B. फर्स्ट एलईडी, द फर्स्ट इनपुट ए कैन बी डिनोटेड बाय द ग्रीन एलईडी, द ऑन कंडीशन इज नोटेड एज 1 एंड ऑफ कंडीशन नोटेड एज 0 एंड द सेकेंड एलईडी डिनोटेड एज येलो एलईडी, वन कंडीशन इज ऑन कंडीशन ऑफ दिस एंड ऑफ कंडीशन ऑफ दिस एलईडी मीन्स 0. सो नाउ वी जस्ट चेक द रिजल्ट. सो जस्ट कंपेयर इट विद दैट एम एस पेंट फाइल, जस्ट कंपेयर इट विद दैट एम एस पेंट फाइल. सो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ वी कैन नोन एज एक्सोर गेट, नाउ हाउ वी नोन एज हाफ एडर. सो वेन एवर सी द ट्रुथ टेबल ऑफ हाफ एडर, वेन एवर ए एंड बी बोथ इनपुट्स आर 0 0, देन द सम कैरी सम आउटपुट इज 0 एंड कैरी आउटपुट इज ऑल्सो 0. सो सी हियर द ए इनपुट इज इन ऑफ पोजिशन एंड बी इनपुट इज इन ऑफ पोजिशन, और द ग्रीन एलईडी ऑफ इनपुट इज नॉट ऑन एंड येलो एलईडी ऑफ इनपुट इज ऑल्सो नॉट ऑन इन ऑफ कंडीशन. इट मीन्स बोथ इनपुट्स आर 0 0. एट द सेम टाइम द सम आउटपुट इज 0 एंड कैरी आउटपुट इज 0. सम एलईडी दैट इज ऑफ रेड कलर इज ऑल्सो नॉट ऑफ इन ऑफ कंडीशन एंड द कैरी आउटपुट इज ऑल्सो 0. इट मीन्स द येलो एलईडी ऑफ कैरी ऑल्सो इन ऑफ कंडीशन. सो एट 0 0 बोथ द सम एंड कैरी आर 0 0. वेन एवर द फर्स्ट इनपुट ए इज 0 बट बी इज 1, देन सम विल बी 1 एंड कैरी विल बी 0. नाउ वी चेक वेन एवर द फर्स्ट इनपुट इज 0 बट द सेकेंड इनपुट इज 1. सी दिस येलो एलईडी नाउ ऑन, इट मीन्स 1, एंड द ग्रीन एलईडी इज ऑफ, इट मीन्स 0 1 इज द इनपुट. नाउ वट इज द आउटपुट, वट इज द आउटपुट एट दिस टाइम? द सम आउटपुट विच रिप्रेजेंटेड हियर बाय रेड एलईडी इज ऑन बट द कैरी आउटपुट इज ऑफ. सो दैट इज अ क्लियर इंडिकेशन, दैट इज अ क्लियर इंडिकेशन. It increases the size. Okay, now see once again I off these two switches so you understand this is the off conditions. Yes, now see again whenever both inputs are 0 0, when both inputs are 0 0 means in off position, the output sum and carry is also in 0 0. Whenever first input A is 0 but B is 1, see B is 1. Now what happen? This red LED, that is sum output is 1 and the carry output is 0. The sum output is 1 but the carry output is 0. Now we see the 1 0 position. At the first input is 1 and the second input is 0. So at the 1 0 position, again the sum output is 1 and the carry output is 0. At the 1 0 position, again the sum output is 1 and the carry output is 0. And at last, at the position of 1 1, what will happen? We know that at the 1 0 position, 1 0 position. Now see, kindly wait. Yeah, too much. Okay. Now see at the 1 1 position. The first input is 1. Hello, both LEDs are on. Now at this time, see red LED. The sum output is 0, but the carry output is on. Now once again we check the results. If both these are 0 0, means green LED and yellow LED both are in off position, then the red LED of sum and the yellow LED of carry both are in off position. So at 0 0 both are 0 0. At 0 1, so a green LED is 0 because it is off and yellow LED is on, carry is 0. Now check at 1 0, so this green LED is on because 1 and yellow LED is off because 0. So at 1 0 position, again the output remains same. Sum output is high and carry output is low. It means sum is 1 and carry is 0. Red LED is on and yellow LED is off. And if both inputs are on, then what will happen? If both inputs are on, which is indicated by the green LED on condition of input and yellow LED on condition of input, the output will be 0 1. 0 1 means the sum LED is in off position and the yellow LED is in on position. So this is the practical on multisim. This is the practical of half adder and the verification of the truth table on half adder. Okay. So I think you might understand, and there is a little bit of interruption in between in mid of this session because of the electricity cutoff. Okay, no problem. So this all about your half adder and its verification. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, dear students, so if you have any query, then